What's up everybody, Usama here and you're watching Tech with Usama. This is the speed test between the Samsung Galaxy Note 10 and the OnePlus 7 Pro. Earlier I posted a speed test between the Snapdragon Note 10 Plus and the OnePlus 7 Pro, and now is the time to put the lighter Note 10 against the best of OnePlus. First off, we have the Samsung Galaxy Note 10 with the Exynos 98257 7nm processor. The RAM in this Note 10 is of 8GB and its internal storage is 256GB based on the UFS 3.0 standard. Note 10 is powered by a 3500mAh battery with 25W fast charging support, and on the software end, the Note 10 runs on the Android 9 Pie with the Samsung One UI. And secondly, we have the OnePlus 7 Pro. This unit comes with the Snapdragon 855 7nm processor and it's got a RAM of 12GB. OnePlus 7 Pro also has a 256GB UFS 3.0 internal storage, and on the power end, this phone has got a 4000mAh battery which can be charged with the 30W warp charger. OnePlus 7 Pro is also powered by the Android 9 Pie, but this one is seen by the Oxygen OS UI. Before we begin with the speed test, I would like to tell you that this test is being conducted on freshly booted up phones. This is an extensive test that takes many aspects into account. You will see benchmark test, first party, third party, and then games loading speed test. During the test, the phones were using the same settings and preferences. All the apps and software of phones were on their latest versions. The OnePlus 7 Pro here is using the QHD Plus resolution, and the Note 10 is using the Full HD Plus resolution. Furthermore, if you are new here, it would be really nice if you can hit that subscribe button and the bell icon too. Let's start the speed test with the reboot test first of all. Upon restarting these phones, I found that the Note 10 surprisingly beats the OnePlus 7 Pro. It really looks like this one is going to be a tough fight. For the unlocking, the optical reader on the OnePlus 7 Pro is faster than the ultrasonic fingerprint scanner of the Note 10, but keep in mind that the ultrasonic scanner is more secure. The OnePlus 7 Pro also wins for the Face ID unlock. Its motorized camera pops up faster than the Note 10's unlocking algorithm. And then I ran the N223D benchmark test. As you know that this is a huge test and puts the phones through a lot of stress. The OnePlus 7 Pro with the Snapdragon 855 completely smashed the Note 10. OnePlus 7 Pro also maintains a great battery and CPU temperature with all that load on it. And for the Geekbench 4 test, the OnePlus 7 Pro once again beaten the Galaxy Note 10. And lastly, for the AndroBench, it was a close call between these phones. The results were almost similar. We can now start the real speed test with the stock apps. You can see that there are no apps running in the background right now. Phone is the first app and it's a tie between these phones. Messages, it's a tie as well. Settings, the OnePlus 7 Pro loaded the settings faster. Camera is also better on the OnePlus 7 Pro. Let's go ahead and try launching some third party applications now. First of all, we have Facebook, which looks better on the OnePlus 7 Pro. Next up is Twitter. Twitter loaded faster on the OnePlus 7 Pro, and when we try scrolling up and down, we can see that the 90Hz display on the OnePlus 7 Pro is making a huge difference. The scrolling on OnePlus 7 Pro is much more smooth than the Galaxy Note 10. I must say that I'm impressed by this 90Hz display here. Next up we have Instagram application. Instagram loaded on the OnePlus 7 Pro faster as well, and when we try to scroll Instagram, it scrolls much better on the OnePlus 7 Pro. There are no lags at all. It's fast and it's very smooth once again. Next up we have the Snapchat application. Snapchat was slightly better on the OnePlus 7 Pro. We have the YouTube app now. It looks like a tie between these phones. And now we have the Google Chrome browser. We will try launching a couple of websites on these phones. The OnePlus 7 Pro seems to be doing a good job with the loading and the scrolling. Let's try launching another website now. Both phones are connected to the same Wi-Fi source, and the OnePlus 7 Pro is doing a great job with the scrolling and with the loading as mentioned earlier. So let's go back and launch Gmail now. Gmail looked better on the OnePlus 7 Pro. Google Maps are also better on the OnePlus 7 Pro. It's a tie between the phones for the Play Store as well. Quora looks better on the OnePlus 7 Pro. Pinterest is also loading faster on the OnePlus 7 Pro. It's a tie for Adobe Acrobat Reader. Spotify was also better on the OP 7 Pro. Let's try editing a picture in the Snapseed application. The phone that will edit the picture earlier will be the winner for this one. I am going to select a same picture on both phones, and I will apply the same filter as well. And the OnePlus 7 Pro, as you can see, that is doing a fabulous job. Next up is the MX player. OnePlus 7 Pro it is once again. We have the Cam Scanner application. It's a tie once again. The Viva video. I am going to edit a small video clip. I will apply the same filter on a video clip and then export it. The phone that will process the video clip earlier is going to be the winner. So let's go ahead and do this. The Galaxy Note 10 is doing good. Yes, the Galaxy Note 10 wins for the video editing. Next up, we have the Netflix application. Netflix seems to be better on the Galaxy Note 10. And now we have a bunch of games. The Pokemon Masters, first of all. Pokemon Masters seems to be doing good on the OnePlus 7 Pro. And yes, we can say that the OnePlus 7 Pro has loaded the Pokemon Masters faster. Subway Surfers. OnePlus 7 Pro has aced this speed test once again. It's a tie for the rope rescue game between these phones. We have the sticky blocks now. The OnePlus 7 Pro is loading it faster. We can now go ahead and launch the Temple Run 2. Temple Run 2 is also faster on the OnePlus 7 Pro. We will just leave this game in the RAM and go ahead with the bigger games. The S-Fold 9 is up next. We are going to launch the S-Fold 9 now. Let's see which phone loads it faster. The OnePlus 7 Pro it is for S-Fold 9 as well. This phone is doing really good. Lastly we have the PUBG Mobile. PUBG Mobile is loading. It already looks a little bit ahead on the OnePlus 7 Pro. PUBG Mobile is all set to take us to the home screen before the Galaxy Note 10 does. So the OnePlus 7 Pro wins for the PUBG Mobile as well. We can now go back and check out all the applications in the RAM of these phones. Let's see which applications are still there and which phone is doing better. For example, the Facebook application, it's still there on both phones. It's just reloading its feed. Twitter is also there. Next up, we have the Snapchat application. It's also there. YouTube is also there on both phones. It loaded from the same place. The Chrome browser is also at the same place on both the phones. Pinterest has also loaded, it's just refreshed its feed. Viva Video is also at the same place. The Snapseed application loaded from the same place as well. Pokemon Masters is also at the same place. Subway Surfers is also there holding up nicely in the RAM of these phones. Rope Rescue is also there. Tricky Blocks has loaded from the same place too. Temple Run 2 is also in the RAM of these phones. And the S4 line is reloading on both. Lastly, we have the PUBG Mobile. Let's see the PUBG Mobile is still there or not. Alright, so PUBG Mobile is there as well. It won't be wrong to say that these phones have a really great RAM and memory management. As you can see that all the applications are already there. You can see the final scores of these phones on your screen now. And that's pretty much it with this feature between the Galaxy Note 10 and the OnePlus 7 Pro. If you have any corrections to make or if you have any suggestions and ideas for the future speed test, make sure that you drop your feedback in the comment section down below. And if you have liked this video, please hit the like button. If you loved it, please consider subscribing to my channel. I will see you in the next one really soon.